AI image editors have been the talk of the town, and this trend was started by Google, followed by ChatGPT, and now finally Black Forest Labs, which launched the FLUX models, and they are known for their hyper-realism, has finally also launched an image editing model called as FLUX.1 Kontext. So basically, you will be inputting an image and give a text prompt, and it can generate that edited image as the output. So I'll be showing you some of the examples of this image editing model and also show you how to use this online. So this is the sample input image that they have over here, basically an image of a girl, and I guess there is some white color snow thing covered on her face. So this is the first input image, and next they are giving the prompt as remove the thing from her face. They haven't even specified what's that thing from this face, but this model was able to remove that snow thing, and it has given the eyes, and that looks so good, to be honest. It hasn't like distorted any parts of that original image. Next thing is, she is now taking a selfie in the streets of Freiburg. It's a lovely day out. It has taken this particular face as an input, and it has generated this as the output. So that looks so amazing, and the great thing is that it has literally kept the face structure as well as the hairstyle precise, because getting the costume is not a big deal. The big deal is getting the face correct, and it has really done an amazing job. And it has also done a good job with the posture, because it's a selfie that looks exactly like a selfie, the angle. And I assume Freiburg is some city in Europe based upon the background architecture of the buildings. And next, this is going to be the input. It's now snowing everywhere and everything is covered in snow. And it has also done an amazing job, because here, the previous image, you could see the sunlight and the shadow of her hair falling on the face. But now, as you can see, there isn't any shadows and stuff, and the background is exactly precise. So this model does an amazing job in understanding the context of the previous image and editing it. So they have also given another example. In this case, they are having this particular, a bird with some crazy mask, and now the bird is enjoying a beer in the bar, and now there are two birds are seated in a movie theater, and two birds are now in a grocery shopping, two birds are now like celebrating. So look at the consistency, right? It's super good in maintaining the consistency of the characters. Like, look at the first image, second image, and the last image. They have the exact same, like the hand is, which is in black in color, and their like the cloth is in white in color, which was exactly the same in the start also. So it doesn't distort the image that much even after giving multiple prompts. And not only generating consistent character and images, it can also do great work with text on the images. So in case if you want to create a poster, you can absolutely go with this. So this is the image, you had me at beer, and it asks to you had me at a beer to you had me at context. So it's basically like retained the exact properties of the previous image, and it has generated another image. Change the setting to a nightclub, and boom, that's stunning. Like, because here, as you can see, we don't have that much lighting, because all the letters in this image have the same properties, the Y, O, U. But in the next image, because of the lighting that comes over here from the top, that lighting falls on Y alone. So you need to have different lighting on different letters. And I think it has done an amazing job over here in doing that. And finally, a person is taking selfie in the sign on the background. So as you can see, the person is taking selfie and the sign is there. And great thing is, it has kept the focus on the person, and it has blurred out the entire background. And if you want to come to this website, it's so simple. You're just going to type FLUX.1 Kontext Black Forest Labs. And if you click on the first link, you'll be directed to the exact same site that I'm having. And apart from this, they're also having a technical report, like a research paper. In case if you want to like read it out, you can just click on this technical report. So this is the report that they have. Basically here, they explain everything, the behind the scenes, how they're able to like create the input image with the text prompt and get the output image. So they also have much more examples over here. So if you are interested and you are more on the technical point of how this works, you can just go through it. And I'll just click get started. So basically, they have three models for this. One is FLUX.1 Kontext Max, FLUX.1 Kontext Pro. And I guess this is the open source one, which is coming, FLUX.1 Kontext Dev. I guess we will be able to run this locally in open source. But if you want to try this, you can try this in the Black Forest API, as well as try out in the Playground. And these are also available in these many generators. So quite similar to the FLUX models, because we had the Flux Dev and Flux Channel open source, and we had the Flux Pro as a closed and a paid model. So this has been the strategy. So now let's see how we can try these models online. So here I'm having the try demo option, click it, and this will be taking us to the Flux Playground, and make sure that you are creating an account. So here we are already having some examples what they have done. First one is, this is the input image they have asked us to replace with a panda, and this has done a stunning job over here maintaining the cartoonish vibe. And another image, camera is closer to a cat who's now looking at the camera. So this is the original image, the cat is looking somewhere, and we have people around the side also, but now we have given the prompt, camera is closer to the cat. So the camera has been now zoomed to the cat alone, we don't see the people around it. And now, rather than the cat seeing above, it's literally facing the camera, so it can do great job. And we saw a similar example, right? Changing the text does a great job while maintaining the color scheme, and give the ball and stick cartoon arms and legs. So it has given the eyes, arms and legs for this ball, so it can literally do a lot of things, like, and even removing specific objects. Of course, as you can see, people are here and it is able to remove the people. Not even a single person is there. That's totally stunning, because look at this, there are literally lot of people here, like around 30-40 people. And the main challenge over here is, it can easily remove the people who are like big and easily visible in the image, but there are people who are in the background who are even difficult to see with our eyes. So as you can see, this part here, there are people, but here they aren't there, the people aren't there. This is like super minute, and it has been able to like even erase that people from the image. So that's great. And it can even like style the lizard as a woven out of string or on. Oh, okay, it's in the form of a yarn. As you can see, the knitting is there. That's great work. And similarly, changing the juice and changing the pose of a particular character, it can do anything. So you need to come to the editing part or the generate. You can even go to generate, and here you will be able to choose the models. So here we are having the Flux Kontext Max and the Flux Kontext Pro. So you can just choose a particular model and click here and upload your image. So this is going to be my input image, and I'm just going to like drag this image into the thing. Yeah, this is a reference image, and I'm just going to add a text. So I've just given the prompt, can you add a man opening the door of this car, and send. So it has given us the output, and just look at this, all these images are so perfect. Like, we are having a man opening the car door, and this is the input image. It has literally maintained everything, the background, the car. So it does an amazing job. And next, let's try with characters. So I'm going with this particular cartoon character. So I'm going with the prompt, show her in a doctor costume, and let's see what it gives us. So this is the original image, and these are the outputs that we have got, and that's exceptional, because it has literally retained the face and the hair color, and it has like replicated with the doctor costume. So the only thing is, I'm not sure if it supports multiple image inputs, because I was able to like drag and drop only one image at a time. You can just try it out and let me know. But in my opinion, it's super good. It does an amazing job in editing images and could possibly be one of the best AI image editors out there. That's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.